Good morning. In the last class, we were discussing about units and measurements. I have told you, as far as the subject of physics is concerned, this chapter is an important chapter. So, this chapter must be learned not for the examination, instead for understanding the physics well, right? So,
just a minute.
So, as far as the examination is concerned, this chapter is of course important, but for the sake of understanding the subject, this becomes an important chapter, right? So, I was telling you, physics is the study of the nature and natural phenomena. Whenever we start studying natural phenomena, we will have to measure the quantities that influence that phenomena. We have to measure the quantities that influence the phenomena. Suppose we are studying the phenomenon of gravitation. We know what is gravitation. Gravitation is the force of attraction between any two masses. Say, there exists force of attraction between this object. See, here we have an object of mass m, right? And between this object and the there exists a force of attraction called as gravitational force, right? If I release this object from this height, we know that this object falls down, isn't it? See, when I release this object from this height, the object falls down towards the earth. Now the question is, we may have to measure certain quantities involved in this. Say, we may have to measure the time taken by this body to move towards the earth. The time taken by this body to reach the earth may have to be measured. Measure. Okay. Next thing is, we may have to measure what is the velocity with which the object strikes the ground. E object, earth na eshtu velocity in the strike maadutade, eshtu speed in the strike maadutade. That may have to be calculated. We may have to calculate the speed with which the object is going to hit the ground. Right? Speed may have to be measured. Next, we may have to measure the height through which the body has fallen. What is the height through which the body has fallen down? Just height kelagade bandu, that may have to be measured. Can we measure the height through which the body has come down? Can we measure the height through which the body has fallen down? Calculate maadabodala, we can calculate the height through which the body has fallen down. So while describing any natural phenomena, we will have to measure the quantities that are influencing that phenomena. Similarly, if these are two bodies, say A and B, let us suppose A and B are two conductors, and they are two conductors, and let these two conductors be connected by means of a metal rod. This is a metal rod. Let us suppose this body is at a higher temperature and this body is at lower temperature. Body A is at higher temperature and the relative to body B is at lower temperature. When these two bodies are connected together by means of a metal rod, we know that heat flows from body at higher temperature to the body at lower temperature. Heat flows from body A to body B. In this case, you may have to measure certain quantities that are influencing this phenomenon of heat flow. Heat flow of your heat flow ಅದಕ್ಕೆ ಕೆಲವೊಂದಷ್ಟು ಕ್ವಾಂಟಿಟೀಸ್ ರೆಸ್ಪಾನ್ಸಿಬಲ್ ಇರ್ತವೆ. ವೈ ಹೀಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಎ ಟು ಬಾಡಿ ಬಿ? ವೈ ಹೀಟ್ ಫ್ಲೋಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಎ ಟು ಬಾಡಿ ಬಿ? ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್? ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ ರೀಸನ್? ದೇರ್ ಆರ್ ಮೇನ್ಲಿ ಟೂ ರೀಸನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಹೈಂಡ್ ಇಟ್. ಒನ್ ಇಸ್, ಬಾಡಿ ಎ ಇಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇನ್ ಕಂಪಾರಿಸನ್ ವಿತ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಬಿ. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಅಟ್ ಹೈಯರ್ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಇನ್ ಕಂಪಾರಿಸನ್ ವಿತ್ ಬಾಡಿ ಬಿ. ಬಾಡಿ ಬಿ ಗಿಂತ ಬಾಡಿ ಎ ಟೆಂಪರೇಚರ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದೆ. ಒನ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಇಸ್, they both are connected by means of a metal rod. Metal rod is a good conductor of heat. Metal rod is a good conductor of heat. And body B and body A of course are conductors. Now, when I say body A is at higher temperature, it doesn't give us the complete meaning. When you say the body is at higher temperature, you need to measure what is the temperature of that body. You need to measure body A is at higher temperature, body B is at lower temperature, right? It doesn't give us the complete meaning. What is to be done is, once you start measuring, try to express your measurement in numbers. If the body A is at higher temperature, what is its temperature? Express it in numbers. If body B is at lower temperature, what is its temperature? Express the temperature in numbers. That must be done. We need to measure the quantity in its numbers. I may say the temperature of this body is 50 degrees Celsius and temperature of this body is 30 degrees Celsius. Now the measurement is complete. The measurement is completed. When you express your measurement in terms of these numbers, in numbers or express model. So temperature can be measured alone. It is possible to measure the temperature. It is possible to measure the temperature. Do you think we can measure the temperature? Can we measure temperature? So my point is, when we start discussing about any natural phenomena, we may have to measure certain quantities that influence the phenomena, such as temperature. This metal rod will have a property called conductivity. It will have certain conductivity which can be measured, right? Here is the quantities to measure marvakarthapuda. These quantities, which can be measured directly or indirectly, are called as physical quantities. See, in case of this example, we have measured, or we may have to measure time, distance, velocity, right? Time, distance, velocity, the measurement. The key example, we may have to measure the temperature, right? These quantities, which can be measured directly or indirectly, are called as physical quantities. Yeah, our quantities na now measure modable. Our quantities na now physical quantities on the curriculum. So, what are physical quantities means? The quantities which can be measured directly or indirectly. I'll tell you what is direct measurement, what is indirect measurement, that we'll discuss. My point is, the quantities which can be measured directly or indirectly are called as physical quantities. So, you must first understand what is meant by the physical quantity. Physical quantities. These are the quantities which can be measured directly or indirectly. Okay. Physical quantities. So, what are physical quantities means? The quantities which can be measured. The other quantities are now measured on our quantities are now physical quantities. Measurement may be done directly or measurement may be done indirectly. Right? Direct measurements, indirect measurements, that we'll discuss. But my point is, those quantities which can be measured directly or indirectly are called as physical quantities. Can you tell me an example for a physical quantity? Our quantity to now measure maarabodu adana physical quantity. Can you tell me an example for physical quantities? One example, I have given you some hints. Here, we are able to measure the time taken by this object to fall down. We can measure the distance it traveled. We can measure the mass of this object. We can measure the speed with which the object hits the ground. As time, velocity, time, mass, temperature, temperature, your temperature can be measured, right? So some examples of physical quantities are length of an object. You can measure length of an object. It is possible to measure the length of this chart piece, isn't it? We can measure the length of this chart piece using scale, correct? No? So length can be measured. Any quantity that can be measured is called a physical quantity. Because length can be measured, we call length as a physical quantity. Is it possible to measure? Yes. Is it possible to measure the mass of this object? Yes, the mass of this object can be measured using physical balance. Laboratory saw physical balance of it. Other means, maybe you can measure the mass of this object. So, mass of an object is a physical quantity. Mass of an object. Time of the living. Time of an event. Event is something that is happening. See, this object, when released from certain height, and released from certain height, falls down towards the earth. The time it takes to fall down towards the earth is called a time of event. So time of an event can be measured. It is possible to measure the time of an event. Similarly, we can measure the speed of a vehicle. It is possible to measure the speed of a vehicle. Isn't it? We can measure the speed of a vehicle. To your vehicles, a speedometer will be fixed, using which you can measure the speed with which your vehicle is moving. Exactly. You are able to measure the speed of a vehicle, right? Similarly, you can measure temperature. You can measure temperature of the body. You can measure temperature of the body. So temperature, because it can be measured, is a physical point. Electric current can be measured. It is possible to measure electric current in a circuit. We can measure electric current in a circuit, right? So these are some quantities which can be measured. The quantities that can be measured directly or indirectly are called as physical quantities. See, the length of this chalk piece can be measured directly using a scale. Isn't it? Scale is not measured from another. It is possible to measure the length of this chalk using an ordinary scale. Can you measure the distance between Earth and the Sun directly? On scale, it measure money important thing here. Can you measure the distance between Earth and the Sun directly? Can you do this? We must run the double scale again. Yeah, can you measure the distance between Sun and the Earth directly? No. Anta cases nage. The cases where we cannot directly measure the distance. We follow certain indirect methods of measurement. See, we know the distance between Earth and the Sun. How we have measured? Do we have such long scale? No, we do not have such long scales. Instead, we have some indirect methods of measuring the large distances. We have some indirect methods of measuring large distances. We have the instrument we use, agarama, right? Instead, we follow some mathematical rules to calculate the distance between Earth and the Sun. Other than our parallax method, that we are going to learn about it as well. So the distances, if measured using a scale, this kind of measurement is called direct measurement. If you are measuring certain physical quantity without making use of any measuring instrument, say you are measuring distance between Sun and the Earth, you are going to make use of a special method called as parallax method. There no instruments are involved, no measuring instruments are involved. Such kind of measurements are called as indirect measurements. Right? So any physical quantity which is measured directly or indirectly is called as a physical quantity. Is the idea of physical quantity clear? What is meant by physical quantity? Is it clear? See, it is possible to measure the mass of this object. The object mass measure from Bodala. Can you measure the mass of this object? The mass of this object can be measured using physical balance. From laboratory physical balance, physical balance. you will be able to measure the mass of this object. Can you measure the mass of the earth using any instrument? Do you have any instrument to measure the mass of the earth? Solve your question. Can you measure the mass of the earth using any instrument? Can you measure the mass of this object using an instrument? Can you measure the mass of the earth or mass of the sun, mass of the moon? Can you do this using any instruments? No, but still we know what is mass of the earth, what is mass of the sun, what is mass of the moon. Let me go to that. Have made this, sir. Have calculated made there. Unnilla. How could you calculate mass of the earth? How could you calculate mass of the sun? How could you calculate mass of the moon? How could you calculate mass of the planet Jupiter? Have made it clear, sir. There are some indirect methods of calculating these kind of quantities. Only now we have the measuring instrument use matterla, physical balance use matterla. Instead, we follow certain mathematical methods to calculate it. Mathematical methods if the way. Adun use maadi, we will calculate the mass of the sun, mass of the moon, etc. These kind of measurements, which are not actually done using any measuring instruments, is called indirect method of measurement. Can you measure temperature of your body? In body temperature measure maadabodala? Can you measure the temperature of your body? Measure maadabodala? Yes. It is direct measurement or indirect measurement. The temperature of your body, which you measure, is a direct measurement or indirect measurement? Direct measurement, you take a thermometer, you put it in your mouth, or say some 30 or 50 seconds, take it out, read the temperature of your body, over. Or you may have a thermal scanner, etc. This is just direct measurement. How about the surface temperature of the sun? You know the surface temperature of the sun as 6000 Kelvin. This is surface temperature of the sun. This is the surface temperature of the sun. How is it measured? I don't know how the thermometer is measured. Measure what is it? Can you measure the temperature of the sun or not? Can we measure the temperature of the sun or not? Yes, we can measure. Whether it is measured directly or indirectly, means it is measured indirectly. Right? There is a separate branch in physics called pyrometry. Pyrometry and the separate branch are there. There we will be studying how to measure high temperatures, right? So measurements may be direct or they may be indirect. We are not bothered about it. I measure maadidru bekagilla. Yav quantities na measure maadabodu, aa ella quantities now physical quantities. The quantities which can be measured directly or indirectly are called as physical quantities, right? Can you measure your height? Can the height of your body be measured? Can you measure the height of yourself? Measure what more? The height can be measured. How about the height is it? Height is it? Height is it? Height. Physical quantity. How about whether height is a physical quantity or not? Height is a physical quantity or not? Yes, height is a physical quantity. Right. So this way, any quantity that can be measured is called as a physical quantity. On the other hand, there are also some quantities which cannot be measured. There are quantities to measure quantity kala. Such quantities are called as non-physical quantities. For example, you go to a hotel and taste sambar, idli sambar pagandari antadri. Sambar taste maadtiri. Sambar taste maadtiri, the taste of the sambar is very good. Taste beshade. Taste beshade antadrella, you said taste of the sambar is very good. How much good is the taste? Can you measure the taste? Can you measure the taste? Measure not the taste. Can you measure the taste? Can you measure the taste? Taste measure not the taste. You cannot measure the taste. Taste measure not 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 the taste. 100, 200 number. Huh? Do you tell a number for taste? Can you measure taste? No. Next thing, can you measure your anger? ನಿಮಗೆ ಯಾವಾಗ ಸಿಕ್ ಬರ್ತದಲ್ಲ ನಂಗೆ ಬಹಳ ಸಿಕ್ ಬಂದಿತ್ತು ಅಂತ ಹೇಳಿ ಎಷ್ಟು ಸಿಕ್ ಬಂದಿತ್ತು ಬಹಳ ಸಿಕ್ ಬಂದು ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಎಷ್ಟು ಬಹಳ ಸಿಕ್ ಬಂದಿತ್ತು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆಂಗರ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯು ಎಕ್ಸ್ಪ್ರೆಸ್ ಯುವರ್ ಆಂಗರ್ ಇನ್ ಸಮ್ ನಂಬರ್ಸ್ ನೋ angle cannot be measured, taste cannot be measured. Similarly, can you measure your happiness? Happiness measure panni korthula. Happiness measure panni korthula. Can you measure your happiness? You say I am happy. How much happy you are? I am very much happy. 100, 200, 300 number heltira. You will tell a number for it. You will tell a number for it. No. See, happiness cannot be measured. Cannot measure the happiness. Sadness cannot be measured. Is that it? Loudness cannot be measured. Noise. There is too much noise something. Too much noise on the issue. Can you measure the noise? Can you measure the noise? There is too much noise something. Can you measure? No. All these kind of quantities which cannot be measured directly or indirectly. I mean, direct methods now with the measurement in Kerala. Indirect methods with the measurement in Kerala. Such quantities which cannot be measured are called as non-physical quantities. So, what are non-physical quantities? These are the quantities which cannot be measured. The quantities which cannot be measured directly or indirectly are called as non-physical quantities. The quantities which cannot be measured directly or indirectly are called as non-physical quantities. Example for non-physical quantities are taste, anger, sadness, we cannot measure our sadness, happiness, etc. So there are quantities which can be measured. Also, there are quantities which cannot be measured. The quantities which can be measured are called as physical quantities, whereas the quantities which cannot be measured are called as non-physical quantities. Remember, in physics, we will not be bothered about non-physical quantities. We will not be studying about non-physical quantities in physics. We do not study about place, time, or happiness. No. We are not bothered about these kind of quantities. Now physics or again non-physical quantities, we study only about those quantities in physics which can be measured. There are so many such quantities which can be measured, right? Length of an object can be measured, mass of an object can be measured, time of an event can be measured, electric current can be measured, temperature of a body can be measured, speed of a body can be measured, velocity of a body can be measured, acceleration can be measured, momentum can be measured, moment of inertia can be measured, right? Similarly, conductivity can be measured, heat can be measured, energy can be measured, power can be measured, magnetic field can be measured, electric field can be measured. See, these are so many quantities which can be measured. We'll be studying about these kind of quantities in physics. Will not be bothered about non-physical quantities. Even smell is a non-physical quantity, you cannot measure it. So, I hope the idea of physical quantities and non-physical quantities is clear. Is the idea of physical and non-physical quantities clear? Sound intensity can be measured. Sound intensity can be measured. Right? We are going to deal about sound in a separate branch of physics called acoustics. Acoustics anta first year lage adu nimge. You are going to study about sound in detail there. Sound intensity can be measured. It is a physical quantity. It is a physical quantity. So is the idea of physical quantity and non-physical quantity clear? What is that? ATP. What is that? ATP. Harshini. What is that ATP? So this is regarding physical and non-physical quantities. Now, after all understanding what are physical and non-physical quantities, we need to understand the types of physical quantities. I have told you, we will not be studying about non-physical quantities in physics. Physics, okay? Energy of plants is not the topic of physics. Physics, okay? We can measure energy, right? We can measure energy. It is possible to measure wind energy, yes. It is possible to measure electrical energy. It is possible to measure magnetic energy, right? Energy in general can be measured. Energy in general can be measured. Energy can be measured. Work done can be measured, right? Acceleration of an object can be measured. Momentum can be measured. Angular momentum can be measured, right? Thus, that can be done. So, with this understanding of physical and non-physical quantities, we will now try to understand the types of physical quantities. Types of physical quantities. As I have told you, we will not be studying about non-physical quantities in physics. Non-physical quantities for the physics now, what are they allowed? You just forget about non-physical quantities as far as physics is concerned. We'll be studying about only the physical quantities.
See, physical quantities are mainly of two types. There are two types of physical quantities. One is the fundamental physical quantities. Fundamental physical quantities. And the other is derived physical quantities. So there are two types of physical quantities. One is the fundamental physical quantity, and the other is the derived physical quantities. What are fundamental physical quantities mean? These are the physical quantities which do not depend upon any other physical quantities. What are fundamental physical quantities means? These are the physical quantities which do not depend upon any other physical quantities. For example, if I consider measurement of speed, probably you might have calculated speed in your lower classes as well. Speed hand measurement of the speed is generally measured using distance traveled by the body divided by time taken. This is how you measure the speed. Speed is measured as distance traveled divided by time taken, isn't it? This is how you measure the speed. While measuring speed, you can observe speed depends upon two physical quantities. Actually depends upon two physical quantities. How they are going to depend upon speed? Speed depends upon distance traveled and speed depends upon time taken. Isn't it? Depend after the speed. Speed depends upon distance traveled and speed depends upon time taken. If you know the distance traveled by the body and you know the time taken by the body to travel that distance, we'll be able to measure the speed. Correct, Kala? Agarra, speed is a physical quantity. Speed is a physical quantity which is depending upon other physical quantities. Speed is a physical quantity which is depending upon other physical quantities. Which are the other physical quantities? Distance and time. So we do not call speed as a fundamental physical quantity. Speed is not fundamental. Fundamental physical quantities are those quantities which do not depend upon any other physical quantities. Your physical quantities variably depend other on the physical quantities, but fundamental physical quantities. For example, mass of an object. Suppose you are asked to measure the mass of an object. Do you have any formula for measuring the mass, or does mass depend upon any other physical quantities? No. Mass does not depend upon any other physical quantities. So we say mass is a
fundamental physical quantity. Mass is a fundamental physical quantity. If you are asked to measure acceleration, if you are asked to measure acceleration, acceleration is measured as velocity by time. Acceleration is measured as velocity divided by time. Look at this example. Acceleration is velocity by time. So, acceleration, in order to measure acceleration, you must be knowing velocity of the body and you must be knowing the time table. So, acceleration is depending upon velocity and time. So, can we call acceleration as fundamental physical quantity? Can we call acceleration as fundamental physical quantity? Can we call acceleration as fundamental physical quantity? No. So, my point is, fundamental physical quantities are those quantities which do not depend upon any other physical quantities. Your physical quantities, their physical quantities will depend other on other quantities now fundamental physical quantities. There are basically three fundamental physical quantities in mechanics. Mechanics of the separate branch of that, that we will start. Mechanics, there are basically three fundamental physical quantities. In physics, there are totally seven fundamental physical quantities. Length, mass, time, temperature, electric current, amount of substance, and luminous intensity. These are the seven fundamental physical quantities that are present in physics. So, fundamental physical quantities. Just will give an example as well. First, try to understand the definition of fundamental physical quantities. Fundamental physical quantities are fundamental physical quantities. Quantities.